And this is the second video in this series where I show you how to migrate from Lightspeed to Shopify. And now we will take on customers. In Lightspeed, I go to the customers and I see there are lots of customers in my Lightspeed. Of course, in this case, I have only myself as an example. I click on export, which is in Lightspeed, it's exporting all the customers to the file. Then I download the file here and I go to my files and I see this file, customers export. And then all I need to do is add Lightspeed to the name of the file so that it contains the Lightspeed and customers words so that Excelify can recognize what you want this file, what is this file basically. And now I just drag it to the Excelify app here, allow it to analyze it and see it says format is Lightspeed. By that you know that it has indeed recognized it as a Lightspeed file. And then you see that it sees one customer. And again, you can either press import and import those customers straight away to the Shopify, or you can do the here dry run. If you check this box of the dry run and press import, then it will just convert the file to the Excelify format and it will not import just yet. So then you can download this import results file and it's just a simulated import basically. It's not real yet, but what it gives you all this data from Lightspeed in the Excelify format. So you have all your email and you have two rows because there are two addresses. And you can verify this information like the names, the phones, choose whatever additional fields you want to fill in. Like here comes the address columns. You can check that they are correct. You can even add here, if you add in this column a true value here, then it will send account activation email at the time when you are importing those customers. And by that way, that's one of the methods how you can re-invite your customers from Lightspeed to your Shopify store. That's if you want them to receive it right away. But of course, you can delay this invite and invite them later in bulk also using Excelify, so that when you have your store everything prepared and ready, and only then you send out your invites. Of course, you can also mark true here to send a welcome email. Also, if you have your passwords, and I hope you don't, but if you want, you can just like generate passwords for your customers and then send them out to the customers. Then all the rest of the fields which Shopify doesn't have a place for, we are putting them in meta fields for the customer. So whatever you might need additional information like the birth date or gender or whatever was there, it's not lost, it's put in meta fields. So when you export again using Excelify and include the meta fields in the export, you can see those values and you can use them however you want. All right, and then after you have improved your data, you can like close and save the file and do the real import. And now I'll be importing again the import results so that we have the modified data imported. Then I press import and whoops, it's expected, but I wanted to show you that it failed with this customer. And again, I can download the import results file so that you can just see the process of dealing with those errors. So in my results file, I have here the import comment column, which says what was wrong with this customer. And it says failed, phone is invalid. And indeed, I have put some dummy phone which is not valid. And if I put the correct phone here, remember you are in Excel, so you need to make sure like that you just don't screw up your phone numbers with all the country prefixes and so on. And let's paste it here as well, the same phone. And now again, I save it, close it, do another import, press import, wait a second, and now we see that it's new one customer created. Then I go to customers in the Shopify admin, and I see that indeed it created my account with all the address and phone, and also some additional fields in the notes, as well as meta fields, which you can't see here, but if you export customers with meta fields, then you will be able to see them. All right, and so that's how you migrate your customers. And it might happen that, for example, you have like 100,000 customers coming here from Lightspeed, and thousands of them failed. And then the same way, you just download the import results file, and then you just, from this file, you just delete. You can do, for example, here will be some okay rows, and usually it's the most easiest and convenient way. You just apply the filter, and you filter to show all okay rows, and you just delete the all okay rows so that you are left only with the failed rows, and then you work on the failed rows to fix them and import only those, because the okay rows are already imported and there's nothing to do with them anymore. So yeah, that's how you import your customers from Lightspeed. Cheers!